Thank you. right here. Dear God Almighty, he's waiting. He's waiting on you. And most of all, Father, circumcise the heart of the unbelief. Save today, God, by the power and the preaching of your word. Save today, God, and tenderize that heart and heart that even sits in your sanctuary, even right now, God, because you are tenderizing the heart of God. Look down upon Pastor Faith, Lord. I pray that you will bless him, God, to receive the transplant. God, with Jerry Anderson, God, as he continues to overcome. Last but not least, God, look down upon our pastor. Hear a great amount of fear, Lord. Continue to fill him with wisdom and understanding, God, that he will continue to seek after you, God. Yeah. and the Philistines took the ark of God and brought it from Ebenezer to Ashdod. And when the Philistines took the ark of God, they brought it to the house of Dagon and set it by Dagon. And when they of Ashdod arose early in the morning, behold, Dagon was fallen upon his face to the earth before the ark of the Lord. And they took Dagon and set him in his place again. And when they arose early on the morning, behold, Dagon was broken. And when they had, early in the morning, when, behold, Dagon was falling upon his face to the ground before the ark of God, and the head of Dagon, both palms and hands were cut off upon the threshold. And only the stump of Dagon was left to him. Therefore, neither the priest of Dagon, nor any that comes unto Dagon's house tread upon the threshold of Dagon, and ask God unto this day. For a few minutes, we're going to talk about the power of our God.
Amen.
Power. Grass may wither, flower may fade away, but the word of God shall and will always stand. My brothers and sisters, one thing you have to keep in mind. That is, no other God has the power like our God has. Even when we find ourselves in some Ichabod situations like we were on last week.
Yes, sir.
When the glory of God has departed from our midst. One thing that we should know and keep in the back of our mind. That our God has lost his power. Yeah. Even though the ark of the covenant is gone,
yes, sir.
His power still remains. Even though we go through some rough times and situations, what he calls upon ourselves, his power still remains.
Yes, sir.
Even though sometimes that we have to face midnight situations,
yes, sir.
His power,
yes, sir,
is still there.
Yes, sir.
Even though we have to cry sometimes,
yeah,
his power is still there.
Yes, sir.
Even though we get weak on the journey, but his power is still there.
Yes, it is. Yes, sir.
Even though we have to walk through some valleys,
yeah,
and shadows of death,
his power
is still there.
No,
even though our faith will say, and dad may be gone, his power is still there.
Yes, sir.
Even though friends get you, money get money, change get strange, bank stay, his power
still there.
Is still there.
Yes, sir.
How do you know his power is still there? Every time I can wake up in the morning and I can see the sunshine, his power is still there.
Yes, sir.
Every time that I can see the stars take their place.
Still there.
It's still there.
Yes, sir.
And that lets me know that I know without a shadow of a doubt, he He is real. And he never left.
Yes, yeah, sir. Yeah.
And he'll be where? With me.
Yes, sir.
Always.
To the end.
Not to the end of the world. I don't have to go shopping.
That's right.
For another dog. I'm going to what I have.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Do all things.
Yes, sir.
Good thing.
Yes, sir. I hear you.
Yes, sir. I'm going to go shopping for a little dog. Hold on, hold on. Even though he may slay.
Yes.
Yet will I trust him.
Yeah.
Even though sometimes he has to whoop me, I'm still going to trust him.
Yeah.
Like he brought us page 2 from the songwriter. He tells us, I'm a trust in God.
Yeah.
Where? And his power is still being shown to us today.
Yeah.
One thing I got to keep in mind,
come on.
That he's going to keep me in perfect peace.
Yes, sir.
But I got to keep my mind
stayed
upon him.
Yes, sir.
That's why I can't go shopping for another dog.
Yes, sir.
I got the real thing. I got the only one that can deliver.
Yes, sir.
Well, how do you know, Heal, that you got the right one? That he's all powerful. Glad you asked that question because I went to looking over in 1 Kings chapter 18. And when I went over to 1 Kings chapter 18, I found out that I'm serving the right one.
Yeah.
Because Elijah got tired of seeing Israel shopping for another God.
Uh-huh.
And he said, how long will we be halted between two opinions?
How long?
If God be God, we're going to serve him.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But if Baal be God, we'll serve him.
Uh-huh.
And he said, okay, I'll tell you what we're going to do. Let's have a contest.
Yeah.
And whichever God delivers by Elijah, I'm gonna let y'all go first. And the reason why he let him go first is because our God would have delivered first. Then it said, Baal never had a chance. He let their God go first. And when he let him go first, they cut themselves with rocks. The Baal got no results.
Yeah.
Cutting themselves again with rocks.
Yeah.
Because they didn't have the rock of ages. They made their request known to Baal. But it got denied.
Yeah.
Because Baal has no God.
No God.
But when Elijah got around noon's day, and he saw the power of God.
Yes, sir. Yes, indeed.
Take a bullet. Fill it with water.
Yeah.
On top of water.
No.
On top of water. With some more water.
Yeah.
Add some more water.
Uh-huh.
Got on his knees. Talk to his God. And fire. Hey.
Came down.
Consume.
What an awesome God. We should.
Yes, sir.
Because he still has the power to do anything but fail.
Yes.
How do you know that?
Yes, sir.
Can't read?
Thank you.
Psalm 66 and 7 can tell you. He rules by his might forever. You can get you another God because he put you in an Ichabod situation. But you'll find yourself just like the children of Israel.
Yeah.
Empty with no results.
Yes, sir.
You got to carry your God.
Yes.
But the one I serve has the power to carry on.
Yes, sir.
You got to assemble your God. But the God I serve assembles me. You have to talk for your God. But the God I serve speaks with me. I wish I had somebody. That's how I know. He has all power and no substitute God.
Come on, come on.
Can,
come on,
and will do.
Yeah.
Oftentimes we want a substitute. And the reason why we want a substitute is because the God we have is too familiar with us. No. He know you want to put something with that coat. No. He know you want to put some extra in orange juice. He knows you ain't buying a block for nothing. Israel last week, the Philistines had taken the Ark of the Covenant and placed it in the house or the church of Dagon.
Yeah.
Their God. This unknown, no having power, little bitty G-O-D.
That's right. Yes, sir.
And the Philistines did not know the real and most powerful God that they had in their midst.
Yes, sir.
They did not understand that he alone is the only true and living God.
Yes, sir.
All the true.
They did not realize that he's a God and he's a jealous God.
Amen. Right.
And you can't have no other God
before him.
Before him.
Amen. Yes, sir.
And since they didn't realize, they are feeling the effects of the only true,
yes, sir,
living,
yes, sir,
the only powerful God.
Mm-hmm.
Let's look at the text. There's three things I want you to see. First thing I want you to see in the text is they have the right God in the wrong place.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
In
the
wrong place.
Verse 2. Right God.
Wrong house.
Wrong house.
Yeah.
Right God in the wrong house.
Yes, sir.
He's in the house of the church of that one. This God that they made up, the fertility God.
Yes, sir.
That was supposed to be had made and had me. The utility God. And they placed the Ark of the Covenant
right next to
that God. Amen. That they are saying that it was not the Ark of the Covenant that brought Ichabod to Israel. It was the God of that God that made it all possible. Now we have Israel's prized possession.
Yes, sir.
Ark of the Covenant. We have that bowl of to cross Red Seas? What they used to cross over the Jordan River?
Yes, sir.
What they used to bring down the walls of Jericho?
Yes, sir.
We know what they used to defeat Ai.
Yes.
We got it. And we found a God that's more powerful than the Israel God. But he's in the wrong house. He's the right God. But you got him in the wrong place. And it's a dangerous thing to have God in the wrong place.
Amen.
By the things of God.
Yes, sir.
In the wrong place.
Yes, sir.
No. You don't have to believe me.
Uh-huh.
But go home and read Daniel chapter 5.
Yeah.
And when you go home and read Daniel chapter 5, you'll find out that Belshazzar has a party.
Yeah.
And he gets drunk at the party. His friends that were at the party was drunk also.
Yes, sir.
And he got so drunk that he commanded that all of the vessels that had been consecrated for the use of God in his house to be brought into his house.
Yeah, wrong place.
Right, God? In the wrong place.
Yes, sir.
And what God did was he just took his finger and started writing on the wall. And when God took his feet and started writing on the wall, he has a way of sobering you up real quick.
Yes, sir.
He was drunker than Kuda Rock. But when God took his feet and started writing on the wall, he saw a bad sense. And everybody that was at his bar sobered up.
Yes, sir.
Because God has a way of getting your attention.
Amen.
When you come in out of his house.
Yes,
and he'll let you know you got him in the wrong place. Is required of thee.
Uh-huh.
You understood that?
Yeah.
Brothers and sisters, I don't want God to write on my wall. No. I don't want him to write on my wall like that. Because I got it in the wrong place. A lot of us in our lives are just like Belshazzar. We got the right God.
Right.
But we take it to the wrong place. You'll sober up. You'll have the right God living in the right place.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Since you brought that up, he didn't just write, "Come unto me, all ye that labor." He said to you when he wrote that, "I'm the right God."
Yeah.
You were in the wrong place.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
But if you come to me,
come to
that monkey that's on your
back.
Yeah. I'll be
here. Yeah.
That bottle that you can't put down.
Yeah.
Get rid of it.
I can make the taste leave your mouth.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Whatever your sin condition is, just come to me, man. I can fix it, but. Gentile, come,
I can bring
exactly. Whatever your sin can keep, I got it.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'll be the right God. Even though you're in the wrong place, I can fix your dirty situation.
Yeah. Yes, you can.
He will if you let.
Yes, sir.
Oh, no.
Is that all you need to
build? Down in here.
That seems impossible.
Yeah,
is that any mercy?
Yes,
to travel through.
Fix me, Lord.
This powerful God.
You're praising me.
That's your life.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
It means that seem impossible.
Go ahead. Stand up.
What he can do. What no other God can do.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Notice something I want you to see.
Come on. Come on.
A lesser God.
Yeah.
Will keep on falling.
Mm-hmm.
It's right there in verse 4 and 5. A lesser God will keep on
walking. Yeah. Yeah.
The priest has placed that God face to face with the Ark of the Covenant. Come in the next morning. That God is on the ground.
On the ground.
They put him back up
on the ship.
On the ship. Next to the ark of the covenant.
Yeah.
Come in the next day. Dagon's arms is broken. Feet is broken.
Yeah.
Head is off.
Yeah.
Because they have the right God.
Yeah.
In the wrong place.
Yeah. Come on now.
My brothers and sisters, when you serve the wrong God, you just got to keep propping him up.
Yeah.
All right.
You got to go and get you some crazy glue.
Yeah.
Glue his arms back together.
Yeah.
Glue his feet back together. Glue his face back on.
Come on, here.
And God just keeps knocking him out. The whole service, yeah. With my head down.
Yes, sir.
And the reason why I
Yeah.
And it wasn't until when Nathan came and knocked on the door.
Yeah.
Told me that little story about that rich man and that poor man, and how that rich man took that little innocent lamb and killed and did. And I got mad and said, oh, I sure want to know who he is. I'm going to make him pay it back, and I just might kill him. You the man, Dave.
Oh,
he said, wait a minute. I got to go through some things. I know I'm going to lose this baby. I know hell is going to be in my house forever and always.
Uh-huh.
I have one son to rape my daughter. Not only am I going to have one son to rape my daughter, I'm going to have another son to try to take my throne, and I'm going to run from him because I don't want to have to face him in battle.
Yeah.
And I have another son that's going to try to do the same thing that my other son tried to do to me, take my kingdom. Then I'm going to have another son that's
going to take my
kingdom.
I hear you.
But he got a woman problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I need you, Lord.
I need
to create on him
a clean heart.
And renew with the feet. Hear it. Right. Hear it.
Yeah. I'm trying to hear
me. I've been in the house of Dagon.
Yeah.
And that Dagon has failed me. But now I'm trying to come back to your house. And when I come back to your house, I need you to create in me a clean heart.
Yeah.
Renew the right spirit within me. And then I can teach.
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
As precious your
word. Yes, Lord. Thank you,
Lord. Won't he do it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let him in. He'll do it.
Won't he do it?
Yeah.
Won't he do it?
Yes, sir.
Won't you look at verse 6 real quick? And when you look at verse 6 real quick, you're going to find out something. When God's word is out of place, everybody gets sick.
It's hidden. Yes, sir.
It's right there in verse 6. When God's word is out of place, everybody gets it. Everybody in the house of the Philistines got tumors.
Yeah, that's right. Yes, sir.
And the reason why they all got tumors is because God's word is not in its proper place.
Uh-huh.
They're trying to take it and remove it out of the house of Dagon and place it somewhere because everybody is sick. Brothers and sisters, every time I turn on the news, I can tell God's word is out of its place. Because every time I turn on the news, I see something sick.
Yeah.
When Hollywood stars would mess with little boys and little girls, that's sick.
Yeah.
When a mother will take her child and prostitute her out for a fix, that's sick.
Yeah.
When a man can walk in God's house, kill up 27 people that didn't do nothing to him, bless babies, that's sick.
Yeah.
And it's just reminding us that God's word is out of his place.
Yeah.
And that's the reason why we're sick.
Uh-huh.
You know the reason why that boy is hard-headed and won't do what you tell him to do and acting the way he want to act, living the way he want to live? He just sick. The reason why that little girl is doing what she's doing, living the way she's living, she just sick. And the only thing that can fix them.
Come on, brother.
Word of God.
Yeah.
Word of God.
Name anybody in these 66 books that did what God told them to do and that situation remained the same.
Yeah.
No. That were 10 levels.
Uh-huh.
That was sick.
Yeah.
And they went to Jesus.
Yes.
And Jesus said, go show yourself to the priest.
Yeah.
And while they were hurting their way, seen the priest. They looked at their hands, and their hands looked at their feet, and their feet looked new. They were sick.
Oh, see you.
Got to believe.
Blind Bartimaeus said, I was begging my own sight.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And I heard Jesus was passing by.
Come on, him.
Yeah.
And I was sick.
Yeah.
Needed to heal it. I said, oh! I'm sick.
Have mercy
on me.
What you want to do for
you?
Yeah.
Go by.
Oh.
Your eyes in the pool.
Uh-huh.
Bustle off.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah.
You don't wind up sick.
Uh-huh.
Something about the word. Got another
one now. Something about the word.
By the name of Zacchaeus.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir.
I was sick. And physically, I was nothing more than a game. I was a tax collector.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And I was stealing every time I had
a
change.
Yeah. I know.
And I realized I was sick. And that's what caused me to run up that sycamore tree.
Yeah.
Because I needed to see Jesus for myself.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Bring it out. Sycamore tree.
Oh.
He knew I was sick.
Yeah. Come on now.
That's what he said. Come now.
Come on now.
But today I must abide
in your house.
In your house.
Yes, sir. It's a book.
Because he knew.
Go ahead, preach him.
I was sick.
Yes, uh-huh.
Zacchaeus came to it by night.
Yeah.
And Zacchaeus began to say, I know that you are a man sent from God.
Yeah.
Because nobody can do these things
that you do.
That you do. Except God be with it.
Yes, sir.
And right then, he started to give Brother Zacchaeus that. He said that you must be situation.
Your name, Lord.
He has the power.
Amen. Amen.
Just come to him.
Thank you, Lord.
Just try.
Thank you, Lord. Yeah.
You'll pay. You'll light bread. He has all power. No matter what they say on the job.
Right now.
He don't have power. Well, they say they will never have him. But the power is not in the human resource personnel office. It's in him.
Yeah, amen.
I've seen it happen. Folk that have numbers behind their name, get employed. Because he who's all powerful opened the door. Thank you.